and right. It's to Dom Thomas. Well, there's a big deflection and Dom Finland have the breakthrough right at the start of the second half. It's a first goal of the season for Dom Thomas, the assist king, and now he's got the goal. It all plated to the deflection, but Dom Finland don't care.
Popescu, is it Kingsley's nicked off him? But certainly enough to beat Craig Gordon, it's Popescu, isn't it? It's just nicked off him and Craig Gordon just wrong footed.
Yeah, absolutely nothing that Craig Gordon could do about that one. Too big a deflection.
Nothing he could do about that one. It's good from Thomas. Showed him glimpses in the first half. He wants to get at players. In that time there was an end product, albeit with a deflection. There was a good drive and run and a decent enough strike.
Who was done by a deflection on international duty as well, wasn't he?
He was. Just wondering what's happened to me. Make all these saves and two long distance strikes get deflected past me. What do I have to do?
Well, Hearts, if they're to be champions, will have to respond to adversity from time to time. That's what they face right here at East End Park. Lee's ball cut out by McEnroy, who's then fouled by Whiting.
Just so quick shot, McEnroy. Look at that for the first whistle. So there's a free kick there.
Still only 20, Kerr McEnroy will hope to make his way through Celtic. He's not made a senior appearance for them yet. Did have a terrible time with injury for 10 months with an ACL. Their boys forward for Whiting. It was out of play. Gets the flick on, but directly out of play. His Hearts are about to make a change. It's Jamie Walker back from injury, who's about to come on. And Elliot Freer gets the hook early in the second half. Stephen Naismith also making his way across to the right hand side. Looks to be another tactical switch here.
Substitution for
Smith in the right. Not great pace, but use of game intelligence to try and create things for Hearts. But pacey White and voice strength and goal scoring ability up front now. But might just leave them short in that midfield area with Dunfermline having five in there.
I guess they have to take something of a gamble, Hearts, to get back into the game. But plenty of the second half remaining as all of these penalised for that foul on Kyle Turner. They've got a chase now. It's a big result, isn't it, if it stays like this? It's been a diluted championship this year. I know it's only five games for most teams, but you know, it does put the pressure on Hearts being heavy favourites.
feel they will have a say before this game is finished. As Walker gets his first touch up to Boyce. Can't keep a hold of it though, next by the goal scorer Dom Thomas. For McManus, Thomas looking lively at the start of this second half. He's beyond Lee, that could have fallen anywhere. Halliday just knocks it behind before Dunfermline could get a second. Look, he's through bodies. He's a brilliant run from Thomas again. He feeds it wide and then carries on his run. He really looks as if he's enjoying his football. And once it comes through the bodies, you'll see Halliday here. Sees it late and the touch nearly takes it. He turned up and he's got to scramble it away at a vital moment. Thomas to send in the corner. Your post ball. What a goal machine this man is. There's not a lot of movement, but there's only a couple of yards, but it's a brilliant ball in from Dom Thomas, and there's not much more to do than just make sure you hit target. Gordon on the way out, he's screaming, where's the marker? You can see Gordon there, maybe he should do better, but take nothing away from Murray. We know he's a danger man, we identified that. And it's popped into the net for two, but brilliant, wicked delivery from Dom Thomas as well. He's certainly played his part. Wow. Now, we promise she goes. It's taken a while to arrive, but... A couple have arrived in jig time there, so booking first of the match for Stephen